Snell! We have a lot to do, and I believe we did not hire snails. Snails are for the dishes.
At least be here for your party. Damn it, Luke.
The guests have arrived, madam.
And Luke?
Running a bit late, I'm afraid.
Late for his own party. That man, I swear. He's probably looking to make a dramatic entrance, knowing him. Open the doors, then. We mustn't tarry. Welcome. Welcome, everyone. Please, make yourselves at home.
Be careful with Shirley, all right?
Yes, I'm at the party already, Mom. Yes, I'll say hi to her if I can.
I was just here a few days ago, yeah. And the inside is huge, but the staff are pretty helpful if you get lost.
Thank you for the invite, Anna. Husband still missing, I see?
I should be saying the same of your darling Rochelle, Lee. The doctor's again.
She told me she'll just be in the gardens. Bet she's lying and that she's somewhere around mingling, gossiping with the other ladies. It's no offense, but that seems to be all you ladies do at these parties.
And aren't you gossiping right now?
Yes, well, what about Luke? Should we file a missing persons report now, or do you want to wait 24 hours?
He's around.
You know, I can tell if someone's bluffing. Don't tell me, let me guess. He's finally drunken himself to death and not wanting a scandal. You've hidden his body. I was wanting to give this housewarming gift to him personally, too. It's a plate that owes a wine glass so he can stop killing himself with liquid lunches. Looks like it's too late for that.
Nothing like that. Besides, this is a hardly polite conversation.
Oh, relax. I'm just trying to be cheeky to lighten the mood. It's not like I want Luke dead. The man doesn't serve dodgy plonk like the others when I visit, and he pays his respects well enough. I could use a glass of wine or three, actually. Rochelle's been in a horrid mood. Threw a stilettos at me the other day and almost took an eye out. Not sure if this is how it usually goes, but I blame the pregnancy.
I wouldn't know, would I?
Still no plans for a baby. I guess that's for the best. If it's this bad now, I can't even imagine how bad it'll be when that little baby bump becomes huge.
Why don't you just go inside and have some wine, Lee?
Think I will, thanks.
Thank you.
Karcher's eye a lot better if you wore nicer clothes, don't you think?
Didn't realize the housewarming was going to be this fancy. I would have gone with a nice dress if I knew.
Oh, you're fine, dearie. It's only really the parvenu, those who climb, that come to these parties all dolled up. Quite the black-haired beauty, isn't he?
Who, Ash?
You know, you really shouldn't have turned down those offers. If I wasn't married, I'd happily go dancing with those young men. But you said a name. Ash, that's the exquisite lad you've been looking at all this time. I don't know him, and I'm the one hosting this party. That must mean you know each other. Is he your boyfriend, then? Because that would explain those rejections.
What? No, that's ridiculous. He isn't my boyfriend.
Such a violent reaction. A simple no would have sufficed. Many here would be happy to hear it.
And I haven't been looking at him.
That's right. You've been staring. Quite heatedly, in fact. Although I'm not sure if you look like you want to kiss him or kill him.
It's more the latter, currently.
Just don't go murdering him on my property. I don't want to walk into a room and suddenly find a body there.
Keep that in mind, but are you all right?
Yes, sorry. I just thought I saw something strange. It must be the trick of the light. Anyway, Honor Wright, as you must already know.
Rebecca Gales.
Gales. Oh, the professor! And your little Becky!
My parents couldn't make it since they're in Scotland right now. And Mom says hi, by the way. But yeah, that's me. Little Becky. We met once before.
Yes, oh, I remember you! You were the cutest little thing with glasses! And when we met, you were having boy troubles with this lad called something with an A. What was it again? Aaron, Alan, Adele, Albert, Alexander, Andrew? Ashton! Ash! That man is that boy! The same one. Oh, goodness me, after all these years! I can see why, though. He's quite dashing.
You don't really need to announce it to everyone with an earshot, you know? Keep it down.
I'm so sorry, but it really is cute.
So, this is a nice party, Miss Wright.
Please, Honor's fine. We're friends of a sort, aren't we? We must be friends, seeing as I know about your little infatuation, Becky. Don't you worry, dearie. You'll have your happy ending yet.
I'm not too concerned about that, am I? That's not what I'm looking for.
Oh? And what makes you think that? Doesn't everybody want their happy ending?
The idea of happy endings sounds like they're just for fairy tales. And they are, sorta. I don't think you can just sit around, trapped in some tower, and hope for the best. If you love them, you have to fight for it, right? You're not just going to sit there and hope that everything will just fix itself on its own. Like everything, you have to work at it. But what do I know?
I'm sure the daughter of the two greatest professors I've ever known is smart enough to know what she's talking about. But have you told him how you feel? And it's been what? 20 years?
17, actually. But no, not yet. He can be a bit dense. I was hoping that Maybe he'd notice on his own and...
Well, that won't do. What if you two become husband and wife? He's not to be dense when he's sworn himself to another person. Why, you might just as well consider leaving before the day's even begun.
If that happens, I'll have to give him a good ear bashing, won't I? Whoever anyone ends up with, it's not going to be a perfect relationship anyway. There's going to be things you'll love and things you'll hate about the other person. We're just humans. It's funny. Here I am, trying to give you advice when you did the very same thing back then. I remember you giving me a makeover when we were still kids. And you were the first I told anyone about my... crush.
Good evening, ladies and gents. Enjoying the party? I hope I'm not too late in welcoming you all to the right mansion. Welcome one and all to our humble abode. Tonight, if you have yet to find yourself in your roles, you are our ladies and lords of the court of your king and queen, if you would excuse my presumptuousness. So enjoy the feast that has been laid out for your senses, as we only allowed the best to be served. Enjoy the rest of your night, everyone!
Feeling ill, Rochelle? Perhaps you need to sit down and...
No! Shut it, you monster! I ain't talking to you! I'm talking to this scumbag over here! You bloody bastard, standing there with your smarmy smile!
Watch your tongue! You're on thin ice, Rochelle! Where's your husband? Who even invited you?
I did.
And I told you with great emphasis not to. Now we have a drunk, hormonal, pregnant woman causing a stir. What is even going on?
I don't know. But Rochelle, do calm down before you hurt yourself. I can't understand a word you're saying.
Where is that husband of yours? Lay! Collect your wife right now!
Don't you fucking talk like I'm not here and you're not responsible, you ass! You told me that I should wait for you in the gardens!
Excuse me? What is this nonsense you're going on about?
Crazy talk! That's all it is! Just completely and utterly mad! Has anyone seen the Chief Inspector?
I am pregnant! With your little bastard! You promised me you'll take responsibility. God damn it, Luke! I finally got you to talk to me after months of silence, and you do this to me!
What do you mean you're pregnant with... Luke, is this true?
Lies and slander, woman! Security! Johans, take her out of here before she makes an even bigger fool of herself!
No, no, you do not do this to me! I was so ready to leave my stupid oaf of a husband. I told you to leave that damn wife of yours. Look at her. Does she look like she wants a baby? Does she look like she could take care of a baby?
I'm so sorry for her behavior. She's been under a lot of stress and the alcohol. Talking nonsense, that's all it is. You're not allowed to drink because of the baby, Shelley. What are you thinking?
Nothing to see here, people. Move along.
I invite you, my friend, into my house on a day of merriment, and you insult my name and accuse my husband of infidelity? What have I ever done to make you treat us with such disrespect? You are no longer welcome in any of our estates, our properties, and our businesses. And we will no longer patronize yours. Now, escort the girl and make sure she isn't standing even an inch within our grounds. You won't show your face to me ever again if you know what is good for you, Rochelle. Take her away. And you, we are going to talk about this, Lucille Mitchell Wright. Not now, but we will talk about this.
Right, I swear that is not my child, no matter what that woman says. Hannah, darling, you believe me, don't you?
I believe that it isn't your child, but you never said that you did not cheat on me with her. We'll have a talk about that tomorrow, among other things.
What for? What other things?
About us, Luke. This isn't right, this doubting each other and not talking. That's why we'll talk. If anyone needs me, I'll be in our room. I'm in no mood to be talking with anyone about anything. Especially nosy baggers who have no business with any of it.
Should I be worried? Scared? Because you know threats do not work with me, Hannah.
None of those. You should know I'm not your enemy, Luke. I need rest. That's all.
Of course. Of course. You must be so tired. You've earned some peace. I'll take over the party from here.
Good night, love.
Good night, Buttercup.
Nap time is over, Kinder. Time to go.
He's energetic. And you aren't drunk. That, or you are getting better with handling your hangovers without your dog hairs. Should I be looking out the window to see if the sky has turned red and if pigs have started to fly?
I am, unfortunately, completely sober, Hannah.
And how does it feel not being hungover?
Still miserable.
It'll get better.
Or so they say. You wanted to talk about something.
You know, for once, I wish you were hungover. Maybe this isn't the best time for this talk.
No, please. I do not like loose ends. And this is a bloody ugly loose end.
Then, first things first, I want you to be honest with me. Just between the two of us. Without others to impress. Without people listening in. Just you and me. Did you or did you not sleep with Rochelle Lee and got her pregnant?
I didn't get her pregnant. But the thought of having a child with her? Can you just imagine it? Or rather, don't. I can already see it. It'll look like that ruddy pig boy from that young wizard book.
I don't care about Once Upon a Time. What I'm asking is if you were with her the other night during my party.
She made me meet with her the night of your party. But I swear, I only agreed to go so that I could tell her I wasn't having none of it. It isn't my baby. I don't even think it's Lee's. Poor bloke. I mean, I probably slept with her once. We were probably incredibly drunk, but that would have been a long time ago before she was preggo.
Are you sure, Luke? You're not making anything up or leaving anything out?
Of course not. I swear it on my mother's grave. Well, if that's all you wanted to talk about, you shouldn't have made me worry.
For the sake of my sanity and for the sake of our marriage, I'll pretend that you never said any of that. Are you sure you aren't drunk now? Would you like something to drink? Because I'm not done. I have something else to tell you.
No thanks. Maybe I will after this little talk you wanted to have. I already told you, and you already said you believe me that the brat isn't my child. I already spilled that I might have had drunken sex with her once, and you wish to wipe that off your memory. So do we have anything else to talk about? Because have at it. I'm all ears.
You're pretty miffed for someone who just admitted to his wife that he's cheated.
And you're stalling. I can tell that incident has you shaken up. So why don't you just spit it out and get this all over with?
I'm pregnant.
What? Come again?
You heard me.
You've got to be kidding, right? This must be some kind of joke. Are you taking the piss at me? Because, woman, I don't need a second fake pregnancy. This is Anna, darling. I need some air. How long have you been?
3 months. And the twins. Although we don't know yet if they're a boy or a girl or both.
Good God! Twins, I'm going to be a father to two tiny, tiny, tiny babies. Breathe, Luke. Breathe.
Goodness, Luke, I'm the one who's pregnant here, not you.
No, don't judge me. Stay away.
What is going on here?
Und tschüss. All the Schweinehunde must leave, including you, Chef Inspector. This one is very problematic and will not leave.
No, you can't make me leave! I need to stay here for her! I need to help her!
Oh, Rochelle? She's probably already at home, dearie. Or she might have already gone and skipped down. Who knows?
Oh, for the love of... There's no point talking logic in him. Lee, go home. You're drunk.
Can't you hear her crying? She was crying, just weeping and in so much pain last night. I couldn't help her. Drunk sobbing bastard that I am. But my help, she needs my help. Tell your fucking stupid lapdog to let go of me, Luke! Or I'm gonna knock him down and I'm gonna knock the two of you down too!
Language! I've already dealt with your wife, so don't make me deal with you, Lee. Or I swear I'll...
Hannah, enough. Don't stress yourself over him. It'll be bad for the twins. So go back to your breakfast and let me handle this, okay?
Are you sure?
Why wouldn't I be? Now, go ahead and do something less stressful.
Yes, Hana, go buy a mansion in the middle of nowhere. Good idea. Great plan.
Here. Who's this?
Good morning, Becky.
Hannah? Wait, how did you get my number?
You responded to your RSVP through the phone. It's all saved in here, of course. I thought I'd like to say hi and make plans and get together sometime. Also, I'd love to hear news about your mother and father and about you, my dear. Oh, I hope I didn't wake you up.
Oh, you're good. It's sports day at school today, so I was just prepping for that.
Figures that you'd be a teacher as well. I'm sh-
Don't know about that.
Mathematics?
History, actually. Anyway, it's real nice to know you've got my number. I was going to ask for yours because Mom wanted to keep in touch.
You could have asked, silly girl. I would have gladly given it to you.
Couldn't, though, because, well, the thing that happened. But really, I'm sorry, though. I gotta run. School, schedule, stuff. Is there anything else you want to say? Don't want to use the mobile while driving.
Oh, of course, of course. I shouldn't keep you. But I wanted to thank you for your company yesterday.
Not a problem.
And for that other thing as well.
What more now?
For what you said to me. With what had happened. It's been very helpful in... I will not be happy.
Hana? Hana, what is going on in here?
Why are you?
Prince. Luke, please.
What happened here? Who did this to you?
I don't know. I am so sorry.
Shh, it's all right. You're safe now, Hana. You're safe now.
You could use the save. You looked like you weren't doing too hot back there. Do we need to call a doctor or something?
Oh no, I'll just be needing some fresh air, that's all. Some help getting out of here would be much appreciated.
Sure, that won't be a problem. I wanted to get away from this drama too anyway. Just... Hey, Zachary! Hey, Zach!
Becca! This is a real hey, Miss Wright.
Zachary, I told you to call me Hana. Did I not?
Yeah, you did. So this is what you called me for. We gonna get Hana out of here?
That'd be great. Hey, I gotta go back in there. Completely forgot my bag like an airhead, and I'll see if I can tag Ash on the way out. You'll be fine here, right, Hana?
Not to worry, dearie. I'll just be right here.
Zach will be with you if you need anything.
Zachary?
Yeah, you need something?
I was only going to say how nice it is to see you again.
Oh, okay. You okay there, Hana? I mean, of course you're not okay after what happened in there. I mean, that was terrible. But you...
I'm fine. Thank you for your concern. I should be asking you the same thing. I remember you being a lot more eloquent.
Oh, yeah. I'm just not too good with staying too long in a crowded room. Or handling intense drama, you know. Sorry about my clothes. Didn't think there'd be a dress code. Not that I have anything that nice to wear to a shindig like this. I dig nice, small, simple parties, so this is a real doozy for me.
And do you host your own nice, small, and simple parties often?
Only when there's occasion, birthdays and stuff. Those are a lot more fun for me, and I can be a lot more selective about letting only the people I'm cool with attend, right? I get to pick the food, too. Of course, I make most of them myself. There's usually a dozen people or less, and all we really do is just hang out. Maybe do some grilling, karaoke, dancing, you know, the usual.
That sounds nice.
Yeah. You sure you're all right? You aren't exactly being eloquent yourself, as you put it. You must have something you want to get off your chest.
I don't know, Zachary. What am I supposed to say?
You can scream merde if you want. I won't snitch.
You want to know what I think? How I feel? I think my friend may have slept with my husband. At least, I'm pretty sure she isn't pregnant with his baby, which isn't much now, is it? My husband is a selfish, pretentious, bloody sack of shite, and... Ugh! You know what? I don't give a flying fuck anymore! My God!
Well, that ain't good. Not giving a crap won't make the problem go away.
I'm going to ask him for a break, Zachary. I'm not going to pretend that there isn't a problem, but I just need to step back.
Fair enough. As long as you don't just up and disappear on him, I suppose.
Yes. Now can we please stop talking about him? Tell me more about your small, simple parties. Karaoke and dancing. How does that even go together?
Simple, really. We hope Ash doesn't take the mic, put on a bit of fun music, and just dance. Not that I can't. But there ain't nothing complex about it.
You can't be that bad.
I'm pretty good with the twist. Or, that's what they tell me, at least. I think they're just being nice. I'm sure it just looks awkward.
I've learned that men tend to exaggerate. You can't honestly be that bad, can you?
What? Do you need a demonstration?
That would be preferable, yes.
It's not like there's music here, Hana. Come on. I could barely dance with music, and I don't want to be dancing alone. I'll just look silly.
Imagine, mon ami. You are an artiste, are you not? With your photos and films and your guitar, you must know notes to play an instrument. Find a melody and a beat. Would it be such a stretch of the imagination? And don't fret, I will gladly be your partner. Where did you even learn to dance, Zach? The 60s want their moves back, honestly.
The college of two left feet, obviously. And I'll have you know, the twist is still an awesome dance.